Commander. Oh, hey, nice. There's another maiden, which is good.
I mean, there's Reggie in the Legends bucket, but Commander.
There's Reggie and the Lich King.
Yep.
In combination with Woe Cleaver,
yep,
that can pull him.
Yep, Commander.
Yeah, I know, but...
Tough, but Commander. Don't want to pass on that, but, you know.
All right.
Baron the Blind.
Yes. He does not see whom he's attacking.
But it doesn't really matter with such strength.
Yeah.
Ain't that the case.
That is the description next. It is, yeah. So, how does it work again? Everyone attacks randomly, right? Like, the hero power makes everyone attack randomly once. Spend all your... Oh, no. It just spends his arm. Mm-hmm. Oh, that was another guy I was thinking of. Never mind. He just, Reckless Flurries.
Does it do all of them or to one? To a random minion.
Oh, to a random minion. So he shields slams. Right, he shield slams to a random minion, yeah.
Right.
Fair.
That's how he does it.
Which seems like a really cool hero part until you realize that
it's random.
He's not quite the warrior that he would be because he doesn't actually produce armor as well.
Yeah.
Because he doesn't have the normal hero power.
There he's got some armor.
Yeah.
There he's gone.
Yep. Yeah. Does he have another one?
Why not play the Berserker first? That's come on, man.
Whoever programmed that AI, maybe rethink some stuff.
I mean, the Berserker would have still died this turn.
Yeah.
Either way, probably the exact same way. You could commander it and rush it down. Or not do it. Commander and rush it down. Do it. Yeah. Seems like a better play.
Yeah, I would have sacked one of the dudes and then hit him in the face though, so as to buff the other dudes. Hey, there's a second whirlwind.
Yeah, that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
But that's always also stupid. What?
Yes, it was.
Why are you always playing a whirlwind first? Like, help. You got a cannon?
Yeah.
Then put it to the right because then it's got a cannon.
I know. You know what? Let's do that real quick. Cannon first.
Yep, always cannon first.
Especially with dealing 2 extra damage on the guy.
Yep. Could be winning in like a turn or two. All right. Never mind.
Well, I can bash him and then...
Or you could just mob, yeah.
Yeah, let's mob him.
Mob is perfect. Mob the flow with him. Cannon and go. All kinds of winning.
Yeah, next one is winning. Like, almost guaranteed. Like, if he whirlwinds, which he shouldn't have a third one, then I would have only had the...
Pick a warpath.
The maiden, but then...
Or reckless...
Yes.
But still, two power on the board. That's winning. Cannon. Azure Drake. Hit him. Would be great if the Azure Drake boosted your hero power. Oh, shit.
Talking about boosting hero power.
Should have Azure Drake first, draw
extra
into the
power, and then hero power. Yeah.
For the win.
Although, at the end of the day, of course, it doesn't matter how we achieve victory, just disgusting that we do.
Oh, that's the one. There we go.
Although Pillage of Fallen is also cool.
We are winning. I'm thinking Armory. Yeah.
Yes. Pillage of Fallen is also cool, but if you only have one weapon, it takes a while to draw the initial weapon.
Yeah.
But Pillage of Fallen is really cool because you can just hit your weapon every single turn.
Point of the weapon.
Also, this boss actually confused me when I first faced her.
Why?
Because there's lovers as a plural.
Yes.
And there are bosses that have 2 forms.
Exactly.
So it's like, oh, if I kill her, will then the other lover appear?
Yeah. No, it's just her talking
but
to herself.
It's just her.
It's like a crazy cat lady type thing.
It's almost like she's talking to a ghost, except that she is a ghost. And her being a ghost, I would assume she would be able to see ghosts.
Yeah.
if there were actual ghosts. I think everyone gets my point.
Basically.
Also, the game would be much faster if you automatically ended your turn when the button is green.
Right. But you still gotta do it automatically.
Yeah, but I'm saying especially sometimes people just forget, right? They play out their turn, they forget to press the thing.
Thanks, bro. You could Taskmaster.
Yeah, or I could just kill the thing and still play my dude and buff him.
Yeah, whatever.
I felt like it was a good play.
It was alright. I think we should still be winning.
Oh, hey, it's an abomination.
Yep. Awful person. Hate him.
Not like we were having a crazy good board anyways, but...
You know. Yeah, that's alright. He's ganging up on our dudes.
Yes.
Tough. Also running cold dice, I believe.
I mean, it makes sense.
Because, yeah.
You're never emptying your deck, exactly. Really, so...
Yeah, play for cannons. Yeah.
I kind of wish I could pull off like a defile type thing where with just the cannons, cannon right? Repeatedly. Yeah.
Sometimes between... this kind of works if the board's set up that way.
Yeah, but it usually not.
It's like a Lord Godfrey type thing.
Yeah, exactly.
There's a mob.
The mob is not bad.
Armorsmith. Not sure if we need mob right now.
I can bash mob. I can upgrade a mob by right. Doing that.
And bash cold light mob.
Yeah, that.
Just put monkey or silverhand. I don't care.
Yeah, I guess we're putting silverhand yeah. Recruiter because no, it's not a recruiter. It's a regent. But so we can get recruits.
Yeah. Trying to kind of get her to run out of cards. I think.
To run out of cards. Was, how?
No, on her hand. Like having to top deck every turn, but
these are cool. Right. Yeah. And that.
And Strider.
Yeah, the Ambers are tough. Yeah.
Strider we gotta be ready for at some point, because that's gonna... Sooner or later, it's gonna run into some problems.
So, do we have a maiden? Yes, we do have a maiden. Cool.
Next champion? No.
Oh, I could have played the Squire, though.
Yep.
I'll play the monkey.
Monkey. All along. That's how we do.
As a matter of fact, you should have played any minion first so you could have actually killed the Strider. Yeah. Because of cannon placement. Oh, God.
Yep. A lot of Striders. A lot of them. Tough. Now if you're going to play a minion, put it to the right of the cannon. So it hits them both.
Yes, indeed. As a matter of fact, the Squire goes there. Right now.
How about champion?
Champion could go there too, yeah, but our hand is already full.
Alright, put Squire. Cannon. Probably double cannon.
Yeah. Probably
triple cannon. You could, alright, let's... The thing is...
The evasion.
Some betrayal. No, if it's evasion, okay. In that case, cool. Just put some down. Put an armorsmith.
Yes.
Put some D up, and then next turn weapons.
We could have, instead of when you said next champion, we could have technically. Am I playing the Sergeant? Am I not wasting him?
Play him. Just put stuff, yeah.
I could have actually Muckless. Right. That would have maybe been really good, because then my other stuff would have been really big. I don't know if I can still do that. But now I can't cannon
militia,
as much.
Just Militia Command, and then you can, and then you can cannon twice. That takes it out.
Yeah,
run it in there, cannon twice.
That means I can't play the Mucklus.
No, but you can just go, yeah, exactly. Like, yeah, play that, cannon twice, and face with the rest. It's good enough. Pushing all the damage now. So
yeah, I mean,
still top winning.
Decking,
still winning.
Winning, you know.
Top deck and win and all
that. Not where top decking she is.
Exactly. Which is how we need it to be.
Yeah. I mean, she's at 11 health. We're disconnected from our game.
Wonderful.